Hello friends, welcome to Rapid Revision for Computer Science students. In this lecture, in this section of undecidability, we are going to discuss the basics of countable and uncountable sets. The countable and uncountable sets are the foundation of decidability and undecidability part. Okay, so let's get started friends. First of all, I would like to tell you that given a set, it can be of two types. First of all, it can be countable set, or it may be uncountable set. If it is a countable set, then again it may be further divided into two parts, that is it may be finite or it may be countably infinite. Okay, so what is countably infinite and what is uncountable and what are the differences between them? So we will be discussing this in this lecture. I would like to tell you that the countable problems are divided into finite and countably infinite, and they are decidable problems. While uncountable, for the uncountable problems, uncountable set, no Turing machine exists, and these are known as undecidable problems. So let's discuss them in detail, friends. First of all, a countable set, what is it all about? A countable set is a set that is, if there exists one-to-one correspondence between the natural set to the given set. Suppose we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So this is a set of natural numbers. So it has one-to-one correspondence to natural set itself, because it is natural set itself. Otherwise, suppose we have got a set named S2. And it consists of 1, 4, 9, 16 and 25 and so on. You must have guessed it right. It is square of 1, it is square of 2, it is square of 3 and so on, square of 4 and 5. So there is a one-to-one correspondence between the natural set and this set. Then it is said to be a countable set. The following are some of the examples of the countable sets. First of all, the set of natural numbers. Set of natural numbers is an example of a one-to-one correspondent with the natural set, that is itself. And second is complete language. Complete language, that is denoted by sigma star. The complete language is always a countable set. Third is the product of two countable set is also a countable set. So we have discussed so far the countable set in detail. Now we will head on to the uncountable set. A set is said to be uncountable if there is no one-to-one correspondence between natural set to the given set. For example, there are set of real numbers. Real numbers may contain anything. Suppose it is minus infinity to infinity. It can take any real value, that is 1.1, 2.0. Minus 5. So there is no one-to-one correspondence between the natural set and this set. So it is an uncountable set. Second of all, the power set of natural numbers. What is power set? Power set contains of all the values. Like suppose if the natural number set is this, so power set will contain first of all 5, no element. It may contain subsets. Subset of the set, all subsets of the given set is known as power set. So it contains 2 to the power n elements. Okay, for a n element set, but here the number of elements is not defined. As it is countably finite set, countably infinite set, we cannot count the number actually if it is power set of natural numbers. So that is the difference between set of natural numbers and power set of natural numbers. The set of natural numbers are countable, while the power set of natural numbers are not countable. Now we'll head on to power set of complete language. Power set of the complete language is countable, while the power set of a complete language is uncountable. Now the fourth one is the number of points in a line. Suppose we have got a line and we have to determine the number of points in between. So we are not able to actually correctly count what are the number of points in a line. So it is uncountable set. now we have got some important points that has to be noted down in details. So first of all is that all uncountable sets are non-recursive enumerable sets. All uncountable sets, that is here, are non-RELs because no Turing machine exists for uncountable sets. As I told you already that for uncountable sets, no Turing machines actually exist. So we classify it into uncountable set, no Turing machine exists. So we classify into them undecidable. Therefore, uncountable sets are undecidable. Now the third point says the number of uncountable sets are uncountable. If we count the number of uncountable sets in the universe, then these are uncountable. The number of languages for no Turing machine exist are also uncountable. That is, suppose we have got the languages, we have to count all the languages for which no Turing machine exists, so it is uncountable in nature. Now, fifth point says that the number of languages which are undecidable, the number of languages which are undecidable is also uncountable. Now, the sixth point says the number of languages for which we can construct finite automata or PDA or Turing machine, or any one we can do, either finite automata or PDA or Turing machine, then it is countable. Now, the seventh point says the number of decidable problems are countable. Number of decidable problems in the universe are countable because we only solve the problem. That is why we know that how many problems can be solved. Now let's head on to this diagram that is very important, and it will correlate the undecidability and uncountability and countability, and that will do the correspondence between the both. Okay. So that will be helpful. These are the basics of undecidability that will be a foundation to the next lectures of undecidability and decidability. Okay, so make it sure that you listen and pay attention to it very carefully. Now, first of all, we know that regular language is a very small set, and it is defined by finite automata, and the language is, for example, it is a to the power n, b to the power m, any number of a's, any number of b's. It is recognized by finite automata. Now, if we head on to DCFLs, DCFLs are deterministic context-free languages. These are recognized by DPDAs, that is deterministic pushdown automata. An example of the DPDA is a to the power n, b to the power n. Now heading on to this version, that is NPDA. NPDA is a non-deterministic pushdown automata. It recognizes the languages context-free language. And an example of CFL but not DCFL is WWR. That is, we can say even length palindrome. Now heading towards CSL, that is context-sensitive languages. It is recognized by LBA. Okay, linear bound automata. An example of CSL is a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n. But now heading towards the next version, that is very important, that is recursive language and recursive enumerable languages. Recursive languages are recognized by halting Turing machine, or halter we can say. And it is also known as, recursive languages are also known as Turing decidable languages, while recursive enumerable languages are also defined as Turing recognizable languages, and it is recognized by Turing machine. Let me tell you that the recursive languages are decidable languages, while recursive enumerable languages are undecidable languages. An examples of recursive languages, the decidable problems are emptiness problem of CFGs, that is context-free grammars, and emptiness problems of finite automata, and equivalence problem of finite automata. So these lie under recursive languages. Now heading towards this, Turing recognizable languages are undecidable languages, and the yellow part that is shown in the figure, that belongs to non-RELs, that is, that are not recursive enumerable languages that we have discussed, are uncountable set. Uncountable set, as we discussed above, are not RELs, that is, not undecidable, no Turing machines exist for them. Now, for the examples for uncountable sets are set of real numbers, as we discussed, power set of natural numbers, power set of complete language. And these are all the examples of not reals or uncountable set. These are all for countable and uncountable set and basics of undecidability. In the next lecture, we will be discussing further in detail the undecidability and decidability part. So let's get to tune for the further videos, and if you like the video, please like, comment and subscribe. Bye for now. Thank you so much.